Hello everyone. The topic for my today's lecture is a reliability design problem. At the end of the session, the students will be able to solve the reliability design problem using dynamic programming. We need to design a system which is composed of several devices that are connected in series. Now this is the diagram for it. The devices D1, D2, D3 up to Dn that are connected in series, so that we have n number of devices. Now let us assume that the reliability of the device Di is Ri. So therefore the reliability of the entire system will be pi Ri, meaning the product of all such Ris. That is the reliabilities of the devices. Now reliability of individual devices is generally close to 1, but the reliability of the entire system may not be good. For example, if we take n equal to 10, meaning 10 devices, and Ri equal to 0.99, meaning reliability of the device is 0.99, where we have I ranging from 1 to 10, so pi Ri would be equal to 0.904. That is the reliability of the entire system. Now, multiple copies of the same device type are connected in parallel through the use of switching circuits. Now, this is how we have the devices connected in parallel in each stage, and as we can see, in every stage multiple copies of the devices are present at that stage. This is for D1, D2, D3 and so on up to Dn. The switching circuits determine which devices in any given group are functioning properly. If suppose the stage I contains mi number of copies of device Di, the probability that all the mi copies have a malfunction is equal to 1 minus Ri raised to mi, where this Ri would be the reliability of the device Di and mi would be the number of copies of the device Di. So this is nothing but the malfunction probability. So therefore, the reliability of that stage I will be equal to 1 minus that probability of malfunctioning, that is 1 minus into bracket 1 minus Ri raised to mi. For example, if the reliability Ri is equal to 0.99 and mi equal to 2, meaning 2 copies, in that case the stage reliability will be equal to 1 minus into bracket 1 minus Ri closing the bracket raised to mi. This will be equal to 1 minus, now as we know Ri is 0.99, so we substitute that value over here. So this gives 1 minus into bracket 1 minus 0.99 bracket raised to 2. And it equals to 1 minus 0.01 square, which equals to 0.9999. So this is the stage reliability. And the stage reliability in practical may not be equal to 1 minus into bracket 1 minus Ri close the bracket raised to mi. Now this is because of the reason that the switching circuits themselves are not fully reliable. The failures of the copies of the same device may not be fully independent if the failure is due to some design defect. So the reliability of a stage I is generally given by a function, that is phi I of mi, where n is greater than 1. So the reliability of the entire system of stages is equal to product of phi I mi, where I goes from 1 to n. So there's a need of device duplication so as to maximize the reliability. So that tells us device duplication actually increases the reliability. Now the maximization needs to be carried out under some constraint of cost. So let us assume that Ci is the cost of each unit of the device Di and C be the maximum allowable cost of the system being designed. So our maximization problem is maximize pi phi I mi, where I goes from 1 to n, subject to the constraints summation ci mi, where I goes from 1 to n and it should be less than equal to c, where mi is always greater than equal to 1 and integer I ranges between 1 to n. And as we know, mi greater than equal to 1 indicates that at least one device copy must be present in every stage. Now Si consists of the tuples of the form f, x, where f stands for reliability and x stands for cost. And Sij represents the tuple which are obtainable from Si-1 by choosing mi value equal to j. That is the number of copies equal to j. So there is at most one tuple for each different x value that results from a sequence of decisions on m1, m2 up to mn, meaning the number of copies m1, m2 up to mn. Now the dominance rule holds, that is f1, x1 dominates f2, x2 if and only if f1 greater than or equal to f2 and x1 less than or equal to x2. For example, there are two tuples 0.7, 30 and 0.65, 35. So 0.7, 30 dominates 0.65, 35 if and only if the following condition holds true. So since this condition is holding true, 0.7 is greater than 0.65 and 30 is less than 35. Due to that, the first tuple dominates the second one, and the dominated tuples can be discarded from SI. So now we have the reliability design problem to be solved, where n equal to 3, 3 stages, the cost value C1, C2, C3 equal to 30, 15, 20, and C, the maximum cost available equal to $105, and the reliabilities of the devices indicated as R1, R2, R3 equal to 0.9, 0.8 and 0.5 respectively, and U1, U2, U3 equal to 233 that indicate the maximum copies available of devices D1, D2 and D3 respectively. So now S0 will be equal to 1, 0, the set consisting of the tuple 1, 0, indicating reliability equal to 1 and cost involved till now is equal to 0. Now the tuple that we are going to take into consideration is 0.9, 30, that is for the first device. So S11 is constructed as multiplying the reliability 0.9 to the reliability of S0, that is 1. So it gives value 0.9 and adding 30 to the cost value of the tuple in S0, that is it will be 30 plus 0 equal to 30. Now this S11 indicates that only one copy of device D1 is being taken. Similarly, S12 is then formed using two copies of device D1. And so we take the tuple 0.9, 30 as it is, and 0.99, 60 is the second tuple to be inserted. How is 0.99, 60 forming a part of S12? It is because of this formula, 1 minus 0.9 bracket square. So this is nothing but the reliability of the system, where 0.9 is the reliability of device D1 and 2 is the number of copies, and 60 is nothing but, since we are taking two copies of device D1, so it is 2 into 30 equal to 60. Now S1 is formed by combining the tuples of S11 and S12, so this is how we get S1. Moving ahead, for S21 we need to now consider the second object, where f comma x equal to 0.8 and 15. So when you take one copy of device D2, so its reliability is 0.8 and its cost is 15. So this 0.8 multiplied to 0.9 gives 0.72, and 15 added to 30 gives 45. Similarly, 0.8 multiplied with 0.99 gives 0.792, and 15 added with 60 gives 75. So this is S21. Now for calculating tuples in S22, we need to consider two copies of device D2, and accordingly we get the tuple 0.864, 60. Now the students are expected to think and write the answer to the following question: is any tuple eliminated from S22. Now pause the video and write your answer. Yes, the tuple 0.9504, 90 is eliminated. The next question is, what is the reason for the tuple getting eliminated from S22? Now once again pause the video and write your answer. So the tuple is eliminated since when you see that 0.864, 60 is generated from this tuple, and the tuple 0.9504, 90 is generated from this tuple. And this is eliminated because if we consider that tuple, the overall maximum cost available is 105 and the cost of the device D3 is $20. So if 20 is added to 90, it gives $110. So this 110, since it is greater than 105, we cannot design the third stage. So therefore, this tuple is eliminated. Now moving ahead, for S23, we now consider three copies of device D2. So we get the tuple 0.8928, 75, and this tuple is formed from the tuple 0.9, 30. Moving ahead, so S2, when we need to find S2, we will combine or we will merge the tuples in S21, S22 and S23, and we get these three tuples. So 0.792, 75 is eliminated or purged since its reliability is less than this tuple and its cost is greater. Similarly, S31, now we go to the third stage. The cost is 20 of the device DI and reliability is 0.5. So this 0.36, 65, 0.432, 80 and 0.4464, 95 are generated from the tuples of S2 by adding one copy of device D3. Similarly, S32, we consider two copies of device D3 and generate these tuples, and S33 by considering three copies of device D3 and generating this tuple. So finally, when we take S3, we are going to merge the tuples and we are going to get this final result. Now 0.648, 100 is the maximum reliability, so it is generated from S32, so therefore two copies of device D3, and this tuple was generated from this S2 tuple 0.864, 60, and it was coming from S22, so therefore here two copies of device D2 are taken, so therefore M2 equal to 2, and this tuple 0.864, 60 was generated from 0.9, 30, and this 0.9, 30 was coming from S11, so it indicates one copy of device D1. So M1, M2, M3 are having value 1, 2 and 2. The three-stage system design has the reliability of 0.648 and the cost of $100, where M1 equal to 1, M2 equal to 2 and M3 equal to 2. This is the reference for the video lecture.